It was a mad rush because we were a bit late this morning, almost missed sunrise, but we made it up to the best sunrise point in town, where there's a cannon here that people come and watch a sunrise. And I think I might have freaking really hurt my wrist because I can barely move it. But anyway, good morning. I woke up about 5 minutes ago and Hannah's still wearing her pajamas.
Hey. I woke up like this.
Oh, yeah. So the next place that we've kind of stopped at is called Garasar Water Lake. It's really dry this year. Right now it'd be underwater. It hasn't rained all year, so the lake is drying up. The sun is rising from this side, and these are ruins from like 500 years ago where the Maharaja used to, you know, live, hang out. So the Maharaja are the kings and the royalty of the area. It's really beautiful at sunrise. So if you want to go see a sunrise in Jaisalmer, come check it out. I'm like falling apart, guys. It's that time now. We are almost leaving for the desert for 2 days on camels. You ready, girls?
I'm so ready.
We came out to this oasis. It's usually full, but because there's no rain this year, it's almost dried up. This is usually where the villagers come to get their water. It's pretty sad. We've been driving for about 45 minutes now, and before we get on the camels, we're stopping at a deserted village. I actually don't know the story behind this. This village is called Kaba. It's about 45 minutes drive from Jaisalmer, and this is the entrance to the deserted village. No one lives here anymore. People fled hundreds of years ago for some reason. Don't know, I need to ask the story. Basically, what happened is the Maharaja, which is basically the king of the area, used to live in the fort that we were walking around in, and he was riding through the village, and the legend goes that he saw a girl that he wanted to marry, but because they were from different castes, the people in the village says, no, you can't marry this girl, and these were the Brahmin people. So he said, since you won't let me marry your daughter, I will come through and I'll kill everyone and I'll destroy the village. So the Brahmin people at night decided, you know, we need to leave. So they, in one night, they left. And ever since then, no one's lived here because when they left, they put a curse on the city. About 30 years ago, people tried coming here and living here again. People actually died, so they left again. And this is just ruins now from 800 years ago.
Will it work?
We've just started our camel safari. We're about an hour and 20, I guess, away from Jaisalmer. I'm riding Choku for the next few days.
Hello.
Hello. Been riding Choku for about an hour now. We've just hit the sand dunes in India. How crazy is this? All right, this is awesome. It's literally wilderness. The thing is, people don't expect this in India. They just think Delhi, busy, dirty, and just a lot of people. You gotta leave Delhi. You gotta go check out the places that are not seen as much. About an hour and a half later, we made it to the dunes that we're staying at tonight. These are the dudes that are cooking us dinner. We're probably going to get a fire going down here. We're in the desert having a nice brewski. Got some afternoon chips.
Welcome chips.
Yes.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Get in there while they're hot.
Oh, far out. What else could you want? All right, so I want to get a photo of you with your head thing on and on a dune somewhere.
Okay. Hannah, take my shit. Hold it.
Hold it. Hold it. Hannah, you're slave.
It's my turn. It's my turn.
Pick up the GoPro. Around your shoulder though. Yeah.
Egg minute.
Do you need a hand? I know how to do
well,
this.
I can't. Oh. Shit.
Ready? Swing it around. All right, let's take this photo. Ready? Let me go through you.